Hi, third grade. Today we are going to read a super fun book. It's called Walter the Farting Dog. That's right, Walter the Farting Dog. I love this book because it has a great meaning behind it. Or sometimes you might hear your teacher refer to this as a theme of the story. And a theme is kind of like a lesson, a moral, what the book is all about, like maybe what the author is trying to teach you. That would be the theme of the story. So while we read, I want you to start thinking about what the theme might be of Walter the Farting Dog. All right, let's get started. Benny and Billy brought Walter home from the dog pound. "Nobody wanted him," said Billy. "But we love him," said Betty. "Well, he smells awful," said their mother. "I think you better go give him a bath." There's Walter coming home, stinking it up. Mother walked in and said, "He smells awful." And that's when they got the first clue. The telltale bubbles in the water. "He's probably just a little nervous," said Mother hopefully. "His stomach must be upset." But Walter's stomach wasn't upset. Walter's stomach was fine. He felt perfectly normal. He just farted a lot. Messy. He did it when he bathed. He did it when he played with Betty and Billy. He did it when he walked around the house. He did it in the dining room. He did it in the kitchen, and he did it in his sleep. "That dog farts morning, noon, and night," said Father. "He can't help it, Daddy," said Betty and Billy. They didn't mind Walter's farts. "So what if he farts?" Billy said to Betty when they were alone in their room with Walter. Betty agreed. Walter agreed too. He sat there, looking innocently around, farting. "Take him to the vet," said Father. "Farting," said the vet, "or rectal flatus, as we say in the medical profession, and prescribed a change in diet." Vet says Walter needs a change in diet. That means his food needs to be changed up. Do you think that changing his food might help with his farting issues? Make a prediction. They gave Walter every kind of dog food. He farted. They tried him on cat food. They gave him hot dogs, hamburgers, and lettuce and tomato sandwiches. They gave him fried chicken. They gave him rabbit food. They made him a vegetarian. No matter what that dog eats, he turns it into farts, roared Father. Walter got the blame for everybody else's farts, too. If Uncle Irv let one slip, he just went and stood near Walter. Then all he had to say was, "Walter!" And everyone would look at poor Walter. "He has to go back to the pound," said Father. "No, Daddy, please," begged Betty and Billy. "Don't send Walter away." "He goes tomorrow," said Father. They pleaded. Walter farted. So the dad's really thinking that this farting issue is a big issue. It's a big problem. And he says, no, he has to go back to the vet. It was all over. That night, Betty and Billy cried in their beds, and Walter looked at them unhappily. "Oh, Walter," said Betty, "you've got to stop farting." "Father is going to send you back to the pound tomorrow," said Billy. This is a big problem. Walter knew how serious the situation was. He'd never seen Betty and Billy again. He resolved to hold in his farts forever. When Betty and Billy fell asleep, he walked down to the kitchen to see if there was anything around to eat. He managed to open the cupboard door with his nose and found the 25-pound bag of low-fart dog biscuits the vet had prescribed for him, which he had made him fart more. Even though he knew they made him fart more, he couldn't resist. He ate the entire bag. "Very tasty," said Walter to himself. He got into the treats, and the treats make him fart more. He's been holding in all his farts. What's going to happen? And then he went and lay down on the sofa. A gigantic gas bubble began to build inside him. "This is going to be trouble," he said to himself nervously. He was afraid of what might happen if he let it go. He thought maybe the house would explode, so he kept it in. It wasn't easy. In fact, it was torture. But he had resolved never to fart again. His future depended on it. As he lay there with his tail wrapped tightly between his legs, he heard a noise at the window. He watched it slowly open. A pair of burglars came through. They dropped silently into the kitchen. "Watch out for the dog," said one of the burglars. "He won't bite," said the other. "He's a wimp." Walter might have bitten them, except he was so filled with gas he couldn't move. They tied a rag around his snout so he couldn't bark. "Okay," whispered the first burglar. "Let's clear the place out." No. They took everything they could get their hands on. Walter wanted to stop them, but he was having unbearable gas pains. He rolled on his back and waved his paws in the air. He gnashed his teeth. "We've got it all," said the second burglar. "Let's go." Oh no, check out these burglars. Walter going to do? That's when Walter let it fly. It was the worst fart of his life. It made a tremendous noise and shot him across the room. A hideous cloud filled the air. The burglars clutched their throats, unable to breathe. With tears in their eyes, they raced for the window. They tried to grab their bag with all the valuables in it, but their arms were too weak. "Let's get out of here." Man, look how far Walter shot across that room. He got those burglars good. They jumped out of the window and ran up the block, choking and gasping for air. Still blinded by Walter's attack, they stepped into the headlights of an approaching police car. "Hold it right there," said the policeman. When father and mother came down in the morning, they found the open window and they saw the bag with their valuables in it. And Walter was sitting beside it. He still had the rag tied around his snout. You have to say, he looked heroic. That means he looked like a hero. "He saved the silverware," cried mother. "He saved the VCR." A VCR is kind of like a DVD player, except for it was like used back in the 80s. "Good dog, Walter. You're our dog, even if you do fart all the time." So now his farting is no longer a problem. His farting was like a solution to a problem. Farting made him special. And so the family learned to live with Walter, the hero dog. And that's the end of our tale. Get it? Tail. Ba-dum-boom. Walter's Wonder Park, 100% natural, gas-powered, it says on the very last page. So I really hope that you enjoyed this book. It was super silly, but that's okay because I like being silly. It's fine. And when we're working on theme, remember, what is the author wanting you to learn? So throughout this book, you need to remember that Walter and all of his farting is the problem in the story. Like, that's one of the things that is the parents think is kind of bad about Walter. But in the end, it ends up being something All right. Make sure you check your teacher's assignments that she's assigned to you on Teams and fill that out and turn that in. All right. We'll see you later.